To the brain. In fact, it's attached to the hypothalamus of the brain, of the diencephalon. Now, the various regions, there are two major regions which I'd like you to identify. They're easy to identify, one from the other. Here and here are the two major regions. This is the posterior thyroid, this is the anterior. Posterior thyroid, and by the way, another name for the pituitary, excuse me. Top of the page, first page. Pituitary, two major lobes here. The posterior pituitary and the anterior pituitary. Now, they're distinctly different. Another name for the pituitary is, as you can see, the hypophysis. So, the posterior pituitary, which is farther down the page, about midway of the first page there, is known as the neurohypophysis, but it's mostly nervous tissue. This part of the pituitary is attached to the hypothalamus of the brain by a stalk of tissue called the infundibulum. When you dissect the brain in AMP1, they remove the dura mater. You probably took the thyroid right off the brain without even knowing it. As the tissue holds it, the infundibulum is very flimsy. What you're seeing here is mostly nervous tissue. The nuclei that you see here are the nuclei of the glial cells. Remember glial cells, rhabdia? We talked about those, I'm sure. Six different kinds, four of which are on the CNS, brain and spinal cord, two outside. All right. These glial cells, remember, they don't conduct and generate nerve impulse like the neurons, but they're very important to the function of neurons. Here they got a fancy name. They're called pituocytes because they're in the pituitary gland. Okay? So all these nuclei you see here, the vast majority, are the nuclei of these glial cells called pituocytes. Okay, so these dark things here are the nuclei of the pituocytes. That makes up the majority of what we see in here. Now, the other things we see in here are the neurons, or I should say the axons, of neurons coming down from the hypothalamus. It's actually these neurons that produce the hormones associated with the posterior pituitary, not the pituocytes. That's a little better. Okay, so these again, nuclei of the pituocytes. And then you have the axons of the neurons of the hypothalamus coming down, and they actually secrete the hormones associated with the posterior pituitary. So these hormones are actually made by hypothalamic neurons, not by the pituocytes. The hormones are released into the blood from the posterior pituitary. Now, what show these hormones? One we've already talked about. That's called ADH, anti-diuretic hormone. What does ADH do? It opposes diuresis, urine formation. So it causes the kidneys to reclaim more water, build up the blood volume, and build up the blood pressure. Means you produce less urine. You're out from that end of the town, you're drinking a diuretic. Okay, when you're bending your elbow, maybe an alcoholic beverage, that's a diuretic alcohol. And so you don't touch any alcohol, then you're usually drinking a caffeinated beverage, coffee, or tea, or cola, Mountain Dew, or something like that. High in caffeine, that's also a diuretic. So where do you spend part of the evening? In the bathroom. So you're promoting your inflammation. If you've been drinking a lot the night before, and I'm talking about alcoholic, you feel like crap. Why? Because you're severely dehydrated. So the last thing you want is the hair of the dog. You don't drink more. That just dehydrates you further. You want to rehydrate as soon as possible. Okay. So anti-diuretic hormone opposes your inflammation from the diuresis. Okay? Notice it's got another name. Okay? You get this bottom page, to the bottom page, your first page of your hormone handout. It's also called vasopressin. Why? Why is it called vasopressin? It is also a potent vasoconstrictor. and you have a major blood loss, there's danger of your blood pressure dropping so low, you can't get it up to your brain. You can lose consciousness, coma, and death. So what happens is, the pituitary dumps a lot of ADH into the blood. This brings the blood pressure up, so hopefully you can maintain circulation to the brain with a higher pressure. So it's a vasoconstrictor, that's why it's called vasopressin, as well as ADH. Okay? So it constricts blood vessels, brings up the blood pressure, but also, again, it helps to kidneys reclaim more water, build up the blood volume, and build up the blood pressure. ADH. Again, it's produced by neurons of the hypothalamus, which extend down here in the posterior pituitary, not by the pituicytes. The other hormone we haven't talked about, but you may have mentioned or heard it mentioned in AMP1, is called oxytocin. And notice it stimulates smooth muscle contraction. So it's very important in labor and delivery. Sometimes a woman may be having a difficult labor going on, hours and hours. Okay? And what do? They give her Pitocin, the artificial form of this hormone, to help stimulate this smooth muscle contraction in the uterus to help push the baby up. That's one function, oxytocin. Again, it's produced by the neurons of the hypothalamus, not by the pituicytes, but it's released from the posterior pituitary. Another thing it does, it stimulates milk letdown. Not milk production, but milk letdown or release from the breast. This usually occurs shortly after delivery. Breast starts secreting milk. So, oxytocin stimulates smooth muscle contraction, important to labor and delivery. Also, milk letdown, release of milk from the breast. Not milk production, that's another hormone. Okay? So these are two hormones. Release of the posterior pituitary are produced by neurons in the hypothalamus. So keep that in mind.
Do the pituicytes have a function?
The pituicytes, they support and protect the neurons, okay, as they do through most of the CNS. Okay? They're not hormone producers.
Okay.
Okay. Any other questions on this? That's a posterior pituitary. All right, the anterior pituitary looks distinctly different, as we're going to see here. This is all posterior pituitary. Okay. Now we're in the anterior pituitary. And note the difference. Here we are. Posterior pituitary. You look up. We just saw. And over here. Anterior pituitary. Now this is glandular. So it's called the adenohypothesis. Here, the cells actually produce the hormones that are released in the blood from the anterior pituitary. We got two major cell types here, which you should be able to distinguish. You distinguish them based on their staining characteristics. Let's take a look at them. Okay, you can see some of the cells here have a distinct pinkish nucleus, others a dark violet or purple. I said nucleus, I meant cytoplasm, excuse me. All have a purple nucleus. But these cells, okay, that have the pink cytoplasm are called acidophil cells. Acidophil cells. This is the top of the handout here under anterior pituitary. Acidophil cells.